Archaeologist Professor Kevin Dicus explores a block of recently unearthed houses in search of something unique to Pompeii.
This ash solidified to this rock-like substance, leaving behind these massive voids. This one I can barely see the end of. It's gotta be meters long. And to me, it looks like the remains of a wooden roof beam. The wood has long since decayed. But an archaeologist finding one of these can then fill this with plaster, eventually peel away this rock-like ash layer, leaving behind the plaster cast of whatever remained inside here. Indeed, these body casts were more for the show, the exhibit of Pompeii, for the visitors coming to see and be thrilled by the death of an entire city.
We're sailing out into the bay to watch the mussel farmers haul up their load for the day. Shellfish farming was an industry as far back as the Roman times. Today, they've replaced oysters with mussels, but incredibly, the technology really hasn't changed that much.
Delicacies like this casserole were affordable for only the wealthiest residents.
Buono. Grazie. Buon appetito.
Buon appetito.
Grazie.
To prove their wealth, the rich would sometimes eat 100 oysters in one sitting.
Squisito. Squisito.
There's such a great balance. The seafood is so fresh. It's possibly even the mussels that we saw drawn out of the sea this morning. I can imagine these wealthy Romans enjoying this. This is a great reason to be at Baiae. This food is wonderful.
The inscription is dedicated to Lucius Cassius Cerealis. He was eventually the curator aquae Augustae, the curator, the caretaker of the Augustan aqueduct. Now, this office was incredibly important. It held great power. Why? Essentially, you controlled the supply of water for all of the cities around the Bay of Naples, including Baiae.
Where the emperor goes, so too does the empire itself. All of the administration. York essentially, twice, becomes the capital, the center of the Roman Empire. To find a gladiator cemetery in Rome would be spectacular. But to find one so large, this potential gladiator cemetery in Britain, would be truly remarkable. The gladiators training there were, on the one hand, taken care of. They were fed, they were trained, they had doctors. On the other hand, they were put in cells. They had no freedom. They were forced every minute of the day to conform to this schedule. These training camps were not much different than perhaps a prison.